Take a look at the animation that is being shown. This is a very simple experiment that you can perform yourself at home. What you need to do is take a glass of water and a torch. Now go to a dark room and shine the torch on top of the glass of water such that the beam of light is directed towards the bottom of the glass. You will notice that when the beam of light hits the air-water interface, it undergoes refraction. Since water is denser than air, the refraction takes place towards the normal. In other words, the refracted ray is bent towards the normal at the point of incidence. Now let us perform the same experiment with a different twist. In this experiment, we are placing the torch at the point where in the previous case, the refracted ray was arriving. Now notice what happens when we shine the torch from the bottom of the glass. When we are shining the torch from the bottom of the glass, the light beam is traveling through water. Now when it is traveling through water, it is incident on the water-air interface. Now we all know that water is denser than air. So light is incident from a denser medium to a rarer medium. Due to this, after refraction, light ray bend away from the normal. Now you will notice that the path that this light ray is taking is exactly similar to the path that the light ray was taking in the previous case. But the only difference is that in the previous case, the rays were traveling in the downward direction from air to water after refraction at the air-water interface. And in this case, the rays are traveling from water to air after refraction at the water-air interface. So we see that the path of light has been reversed, but the path remains the same. This shows us that the path of the rays is reversible. So what is this known as? This is known as the principle of reversibility of light. The principle of reversibility of light states that the path of a light beam can be reversed. That is, even though the path remains the same, the direction is changed. Now, I have a small problem for you. In this problem, we are said that the refractive index of glass with respect to air is 1.5. That is, we know what the refractive index of glass with respect to air is. Given this information, we have to find out the refractive index of air with respect to glass. Let us find out how we can do so. Now consider the diagram on the board. Here you will find that a ray of light is incident from air onto glass. This is air and this is glass. Now this ray is incident on the air-glass interface, as you can see from the blue arrowhead. Now since air is optically rarer than glass, after refraction, the refracted ray OB bends or shifts towards the normal. The angle of incidence with the normal is I1 and the angle of refraction is R1. So what can we say? That the refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1, that is the refractive index of glass with respect to air, is given by sine I1 by sine R1. That is the sine of the angle of incidence to the sine of the angle of refraction. Now we consider a slightly different scenario. Earlier, the ray of light was incident from top, that is from air to glass. Here, the ray of light is incident in the same path from glass to air. Now notice what happens. When the ray of light is incident from glass to air at the glass-air interface, it undergoes refraction. Now since medium 2, that is glass, is optically denser than medium 1, that is air, The refracted ray bends away from the normal, or in other words, it shifts away from the normal. In this case, the angle of incidence is I2, that the incident ray makes with the normal inside glass. And the angle of refraction is R2, that the refracted ray makes with the normal in air. So the refractive index of medium 1 with respect to medium 2, that is, the refractive index of air with respect to glass, is given by sine R2 divided by sine R2. So that is sine I2, that is the sine of the angle of incidence, and sine R2, that is the sine of the angle of refraction. So now we have two bits of information. We have 1 mu 2, that is the refractive index of medium 2 with respect to medium 1, given by sine I1 by sine R1. And we have 2 mu 1, that is the refractive index of medium 1 with respect to medium 2, that is given by sine I2 by sine R2. Notice that here medium 1 refers to air and medium 2 refers to glass. Now we have learnt about the principle of reversibility of light, that states that the path of a light ray can be reversed. And from the previous two diagrams, applying the principle of reversibility of light, what can we say? We can say that from the principle of reversibility, I1 is equal to R2 and I2 is equal to R1. Now we can see that there are two equations that we have from the earlier two ray diagrams. Using these two equations and using this equality and this equality, we come at a conclusion. Now what we do is we multiply equation 2 with equation 1. When we multiply equation 2 with equation 1, we get sine I1 by sine R1, that was this expression, and we multiply that with equation 2, that is sine I2 by sine R2, that is this expression. Now since I1 is equal to R2, this will cancel because these two are equal as the angles are equal, and since I2 is equal to R1, this will also cancel and this will yield the result 1. So we can say that 1 mu 2 multiplied by 2 mu 1 gives us 1. So this means that the refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first can be given by the reciprocal of the refractive index of the first medium with respect to the second. In other words, we can also write the refractive index of the first medium with respect to the second can be given by the reciprocal of the refractive index of the second medium with respect to the first. That is 1 upon the given refractive index. So we had been given the refractive index of glass with respect to air. The refractive index of glass with respect to air was 1 mu 2, and that was equal to 1.5. And we have to find out 2 mu 1, that is the refractive index of air with respect to glass. Thus, we can say that the refractive index of air with respect to glass is 1 divided by the refractive index of glass with respect to air. And this value is equal to 1.5 or 3 upon 2. This gives us a result 2 upon 3. And this is the value of the refractive index of air with respect to glass. So taking a quick recap, what did we learn? We learned that a ray of light in its path can be reversed. This is known as the principle of reversibility of light. And using the principle of reversibility of light, we calculated the refractive index of air with respect to glass when we had been given with the refractive index of glass with respect to air.